Introducing one of my comfort series, one of those that I just go back to every couple of years. And to be clear, I'm only comforted because of how much I love the series, not because of what happens in the series, because Sabaa Tahir, the author, dear Sabaa, she has a way of doing away with characters that I love and not giving me the resolutions and the conclusions that I so desperately desire. Sabaa. An Ember in the Flippin' Ashes is the debut novel by Sabaa Tahir. And, man, what to say about this? The series thus far is 3 books long. The fourth is finished. It is just going through its final revisions right now, and it is to be released December 1st. In fact, I don't do this often, but I did a video of the cover and title reveal because this is one of those series that I'm super excited about and that I've been able to catch on to while it's being written. It's not just a series that's over and done with and I'm coming too late. This is one that I got the first book as the second was being released, so I was a little late to the game, but then I was on the hype train when the third book came out, and I'm definitely most excited here about Sabaa's conclusion, and I'm super excited for her. You can watch that video of all my excitement in the annotation above, but man, this is the first book in the series, and in preparation for that December 1st release, I am rereading the first three. This book, An Ember in the Ashes, the first one, I've read most, of course, because that typically happens. This is probably my third or fourth reread, and I just want to be completely ready for that finale. So I'm going through each book systematically, taking notes so that I can follow every thread all the way through, because I want to be in the know when the fourth and final book releases. All right, so here's the story. We've got two different POVs. One is a young girl named Laia. She is a slave in an ancient Rome-inspired empire. Then on the other hand, we've got a young man named Elias who is in a completely different scenario than Laia. He is a soldier about to graduate from the most prestigious military academy in all of the empire. And their stories, while they look different on the outside, they're actually relatively in similar situations. Well, the story is the intertwining of their narratives and how all of that comes to fruition there at the end. Can't give away much more than that. It is fantasy, I would say light, in the sense of like no one's going around just like casting magic everywhere. The world is more fantasaical, and there are some magical elements that are somewhat under the surface, and as the series continues, that only increases. But no one's going around with wands zapping people and saying Expelliarmus. A few of the things that I loved most about the book when I first read it and what I came back to even on this reread is the prose. The way that Sabaa writes is just so poetic at times. I don't know about poetic, maybe that's too strong. Flowery, but in a good way, beautiful. She doesn't use words unnecessarily. Every word is intentional, but she has a little bit more like character, and she's painting a picture from time to time, and that was a lot of fun and very refreshing to read. It's one of the things that I like. Another thing that I like is the relationship between Elias, one of the POV characters that I talked about, and Helene, one of his like longtime friends that is also a soldier, or a mask is what they're called, that is about to graduate with him. That tension and dynamic from this book all the way through is probably my favorite relationship to follow. That's one of the things that I liked most rereading the book this time, watching that relationship play out, because it is absolutely beautiful and painful and gut-wrenching and beautiful and honest. That's a big thing. Sabaa has a way of writing these characters and their relationships and their romances in a way that is so real. It is not fake. It is not fantasy. In fact, I've got to ask Sabaa at some point, who hurt you? Or what of your past relationships are you pulling from? Because I know there's something personal about this. But whatever that is, helps these relationships, romantic or not, have more layers. And they're just more real because of that. And it makes the story worth reading. This is one of those wonderful stories that I come back to regularly again. I give it 5 out of 5 stars every single time because it's my comfort. It's something that is a really good story told in a really charming way, and you just fall in love with the characters. So if you're looking for just a really good, relatively light, relatively quick and easy read, relatively fast-paced fantasy book that is written by an author that is a person of color with a main character, Laya, that is a person of color, then maybe this would be a series that you should get into. Come on, do it before December 1st. You'll thank me. Have you read any of the books in this series? I'd love to gush about them in the comments with you down below, but if you haven't, please get on this. You've got enough time to read the 3 and get caught up before the 4th and final book comes out here at the end of this year. So go ahead, get on it quickly. You're not going to regret it. This is a masterpiece. And as always, thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video, for clicking like. If you haven't yet, click subscribe, join the Dragon Army, and we'll see you in the next video.